The crew traveled on to New Delhi, India, where temperatures have been recorded as high as 143 degrees Fahrenheit. Once in India, it was still another 17 hours of travel to the Himalayas, up against the Tibetan-Pakistan border to get to the Haimashal helicopter operation, where you can ski above 18,000 feet on mountains that have never seen or felt a pair of skis. Up near the Tibetan border, the road begins to climb higher and the ground rumbles under small earthquakes that keep the road crews busy. There's unlimited manpower here that earns about 10 cents a day. Here the mountain peaks rise up above 8,000 meters. That's above 24,000 feet. High above the summer resort town of Manali, where there's also a small ski station called Solang. When you go to ski in India, be sure and bring your own ski equipment, because in Solang, ski boots are rubber goulashes. The skis have no edges. The kids of Solang have ski bindings that are hand-woven from local vines. And they live in a town where the cost of living is less than $2 a month. On the bottoms of their skis, they've screwed pieces of old used bandsaw blades from the local lumber mill and bent it up for their tips. They don't even bother to file the teeth off of the saw blade. The skis are handmade out of walnut. One of these kids might be the future Tommy Moe of India. Or maybe Scott Schmidt. Their coach, Murali Dhar, is a member of the Indian national ski team.
Skiing in India is different than any other place in the world. We've been skiing here from the last 22 years, and we boys in the villages, we make the wooden skis, and we ski with our own self-made wooden skis, and we have lots of fun. And we walk up, we go up high, like 10, 20,000 feet, and then we ski down. And there are lots of ski areas around here to ski. And now I'm in a national team. I've been skiing for Asian Games and Winter Olympics, and really I'm having fun, and I look forward for my younger kids to be a really champion.
In Manali, there's no need to make a fashion statement. Their poles have no baskets or handles. They have no latest this or that. They don't even own any gloves. And they've never seen a chairlift or a rope tow. They don't need or want what you and I take for granted. Think about the size of their smiles the next time you complain about waiting 3 minutes in a high-speed quad lift line while you're wearing the latest and most fashionable ski equipment. There's no word in the Manali dialect for snow grooming or artificial snow. But there's at least a dozen words that all translate to the same simple three-letter word, fun. Webster's dictionary defines reality as something that exists out of necessity. Is it really a necessity to have the latest ski outfit? In reality, all you really need is something to wear on your feet that will slide on snow that's fallen on the side of a hill somewhere, and a great big smile. A big smile is the most important thing you can own if you want to experience real vertical reality. I've been lucky. I spent most of my life on the side of a hill with skis on my feet and a smile on my face.